trying to predict what the court will do, and in particular how they'll do it, is often just not that productive, because you're often going to be wrong. And so somebody says you can't bruise before you're hit. You got to wait and see what they rule and then act on it. The Mississippi and other states are, you know, waging a frontal assault on Roe versus Wade, and basically saying that the state should interfere in women's decisions about their own pregnancies earlier and earlier in pregnancy. The kind of core of Roe versus Wade is early in pregnancy. Women should have a liberty interest in making their own decisions about pregnancy, and at the very end of pregnancy, because of the viability of a fetus, states can appropriately regulate with a little more of a heavy hand. But Mississippi, Texas, and other states are basically trying to get the courts to overturn Roe versus Wade and allow the states to use the criminal law against women and doctors earlier and earlier in pregnancy. I'm a strong supporter of Roe versus Wade. I'm a supporter, a co-sponsor of a bill called the Women's Health Protection Act, which would basically codify Roe versus Wade statutorily as the law of the land. But this will be the most closely watched case, I imagine, of the Supreme Court session. And if the court were to throw out Roe versus Wade and allow states to use the criminal law to try to go after women and doctors, some states will do that. I don't think Virginia will, particularly with a Democratic Senate. So the governor might have a particular goal, but he can't legislate. He's got to get the General Assembly on board. And there is a Democratic state Senate that is generally pretty supportive of the basic Roe versus Wade framework.